Well, once again, we've made a big accomplishment. We've finished another book in our Daily in the Word series. Today, as James closes out this little letter, you know, he speaks to something that we consider one of our great values as a church. You see, we as a church, we pray to God, both in spirit and in power. Listen to what James writes in the 5th chapter of James, starting in verse 13. He says, "Are any of you suffering hardships? You should pray. Are any of you happy? You should sing praises. Are any of you sick? You should call for the elders of the church to come and pray over you, anointing you with the oil in the name of the Lord. For such a prayer offered in faith will heal the sick, and the Lord will make you well. And if you've committed any sins, you'll be forgiven. Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. For the earnest prayer of a righteous person has power and produces wonderful results." And he gives an example here in verse 17. "Elijah was a human as we are, and yet when he prayed earnestly that no rain would fall, none fell for 3.5 years. Then when he prayed again, the sky sent down rain, and the earth began to yield its crops." See, here's the wonderful thing as James closes out his little letter. His focus, his attention, isn't on the works that we do, but the work that God does through us. See, God desires a relationship with us. Relationships thrive on good communication. And so James writes, listen, are you sick? Gather the leaders in your church to pray for you. Are you suffering? Pray. Are you experiencing some of the distancing effect that sin brings? Confess your sins before one another. Pray that you may be healed. And he gives this great example of Elijah. Elijah, he's just a guy like anyone else. And when he prayed to God in faith, God shut up the heavens from raining. And then when he asked for rain, God brought it down. See, here's the wonderful thing. Our prayer life isn't so much about our good works and prayer, but about the great work that God can do through prayer. A simple trust, a simple request. Because it's the agent that we're praying to, not the activity itself, that brings power. And that agent is God, the God of heaven, the God of earth, the God who flung the stars into existence. Oftentimes people think of prayer almost like making a hopeful wish. And I would say this, rather than wishing upon a star, why not pray to the one who created them? Jesus, he is our creator, he is our king. So today, cast all your cares upon him, pray, and see what God might